Hello friends, my name is Viren Singh. Welcome to my channel Smart Learning Academy. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the fed batch operation, biomass production rate in the fed batch operation, substrate utilization rate in the fed batch operation, and product formation rate in fed batch operation. This is the introduction about fed batch operation. In fed batch operation, intermittent or continuous feeding of nutrient is done. The fed batch operation is used when the substrate inhibition or catabolite depression is there. Volume is not constant. The very important parameter, volume is not constant in fed batch reactor operation. It is also called semi-continuous condition and it operates at quasi-steady state. That means nutrient feed rate is equal to nutrient consumption rate, and at quasi-steady state, ds by dt and dp by dt is zero. Let's discuss the biomass production in fed batch culture. As I told you, in fed batch culture, there is intermittent or continuous feeding is there. That means mi is not zero. Mi is equal to fx naught. X naught is the initial biomass concentration. But there is no continuous removal of product, so mo is zero. Mass out is zero. And rate of generation of biomass is similar in the batch culture. If you remember the batch culture operation, then it will help you here also. Rate of generation is mu into x into v, and rate of consumption is zero if you consider kd is equal to zero. So first step is parameters value of mi, m0 and rg, rc. The second step is to utilize mass balance equation, that is mi minus mo plus rg minus rc equal to dm by dt. Put the values of parameters here and you will get this equation dxv by dt. Volume is not constant, then you have to do product rule here, the differentiation product rule, that is first function as it is and differentiation of second function, and second function as it is and differentiation of first function, that is x into dv by dt plus v into dx by dt. dv by dt is also known as flow rate. Change in the volume with respect to time is known as flow rate. If you integrate this equation, you will get this equation v equal to v naught plus ft. Please remember this formula. Please remember all the formulas which is denoted in the box, because that formulas are very, very important for the solving numericals. Come here to this equation. Here dv by dt is equal to flow rate, then put here flow rate and v into dx by dt, then you will get this equation. Divide the whole equation by volume v, you will get this equation. Flow rate converts into dilution rate, that you know the dilution rate is equal to flow rate upon volume. As I mentioned in previous videos, dilution is equal to flow rate upon volume. If this process operates at quasi steady state, that is dx by dt equal to 0, and when sterile feed is used, that is x naught equal to 0. So you will get this equation mu minus dx equal to 0, or you can say mu equal to d, because x cannot be 0. Biomass concentration in between the operation is not 0. So mu equal to d. If the total biomass concentration is x into v, total volume, look for the change of biomass concentration with time dx by dt, that is dxv by dt and v dx by dt plus x dy by dt, because volume is not constant, and use the product rule of differentiation here. Put the dx by dt here because it operates at quasi steady state, and you will get this equation x into f. What is x? X is the y-axis s naught minus s from the yield equation. Integrate this equation with the respect to time and you will get this equation. When s tends to 0, x tends to x max, and t is the here is the fed batch time. So this is the biomass production in fed batch culture, and remember all the formulas I mentioned here. Let's discuss the substrate utilization in fed batch culture. As I mentioned, there is intermittent feeding of the substrate. Mi is equal to fs naught and mo is zero because there is no continuous removal. Volume is not constant here. Dv by dt is equal to flow rate, as I told you earlier also, and V equal to V naught plus Ft. Please remember this formula. The first step is to calculate the various parameters Mi, Mo, Rg plus Rc. Here's Mi is F into S naught, Mo is 0 because no product removal, Rg is 0 because no generation of the substrate, and consumption of substrate, that is Qs into X into V. So as I told you earlier, Qs is equal to mu upon Y axis, Qp upon Yps plus Ms. This is for the biomass, and this is for the product formation, and this is for the maintenance coefficient. Use the mass balance equation and put the values, you will get this equation. Here volume is not constant, so use the product rule of differentiation and you will get this equation S into dV by dt plus V into dS by dt. Here dV by dt is flow rate, use the flow rate here and you will get this equation. At quasi steady state, dS by dt is 0. As I told you earlier, change is the substrate concentration with respect to time is 0 at quasi steady state in fed batch fermentation, and the divide whole equation by volume V, and you will get this equation dS minus S equal to Qs into X. If there is no product formation and there is no maintenance, that means Qp is 0 and Ms is 0, and you will get this equation. Please remember this formula to calculate the various examples and various numericals asked in various examination. Let's discuss product formation in fed batch operation. As I told you earlier, dV by dt is flow rate and V equal to V naught plus Ft. Identify the various parameters. Mi is equal to F into P naught because there is intermittent or continuous addition of the product or of the parameters. The rate of generation of product is Qp into X into V, and rate of consumption is 0 because there is no consumption of product. The volume is not constant here because this is fed batch culture, and volume is continuously increasing till the limit of reactor. Use the mass balance equation and put the values in the mass balance equation, and you will get this equation Fp0 minus 0 plus Qpxv equal to P into dV by dt plus V into dP by dt. Because volume is not constant here, use the product rule of differentiation, that is first function as it is and differentiation of second function plus second function as it is and differentiation of first function. Divide the whole equation by volume and you will get this equation. At quasi steady state, you will get dP by dt is equal to 0, and manipulate this equation and you will get this equation. Remember this formula to solve the various numericals. These are the advantages and disadvantages of fed batch culture. Substrate inhibition or catabolite repression. In those processes, fed batch culture is very useful. Product of growth associated products is very helpful in the fed batch culture. The production of biomass is increased in fed batch culture. The production of secondary metabolites also occurs in fed batch culture. There are some disadvantages of fed batch culture, that is, the additional instrument for feedback control may be costly. If you compare with batch culture, it requires substantial amount of operator skill. So this is all about the fed batch culture and advantages and disadvantages of fed batch culture. Learn the formulas and remember the formulas, which will help you to solve the numericals various examination. If you like my video, please do like and subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you.